गुड मॉर्निंग गर्ल्स, सो अगेन कम बैक टू अ फ्रेश लेक्चर. सो अगेन टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सम मोर एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी नाउ सम वेरी गुड एप्लीकेशंस नाउ बेस्ड ऑन द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो नाउ लेट अस सी Now, what are the applications we got? Now, the first application will be now let us say, now you got a simple pendulum, or let us say you got a pendulum bob which has been given a positive charge q, and let us say the mass of the bob will be m. So let us say, now consider a pendulum bob of mass m that has been given a charge q and suspended from a rigid support. So now let us say, now initially we are applying a vertical electric field, or let us say, now initially we are applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. So remember, now what the application will be saying, we got two cases. So now case one will be, now consider a pendulum bob of mass m that has been given a charge q and it is suspended from a rigid support. And let us say, now we are applying a vertical electric field, or we are applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. Now let us say, now in this case the tension in the string will be T1, or let us say, now in this case, now the tension in the string will be T1. So now if you come to the second case, now what I am doing, now without disturbing the pendulum bob, or without disturbing the pendulum, now what I am doing, I am reversing the direction of the electric field, or what I am doing, the direction of the electric field will be reversed. Now meaning, now the electric field will be acting in the vertically downward direction. So now let us say, now in this case the tension in the string will be T2. So let us say, in case 2, the tension in the string will be T2. So now what we need to find, now what will be the ratio of T1 by T2, or what will be the ratio of the tensions, now T1 by T2. So now once again, now remember the application. So remember, now what is, now case one, now consider a pendulum bob of mass m which has been given a positive charge q, and what we are doing, now we are applying a vertical field, or we are applying the vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. Now let us say, now in this case the tension in the string will be T1. So now when you come to case number 2, now what I am doing, So now I'm reversing the direction of the electric field, or now I'm reversing the direction of the electric field. Now let us say, now in this case, the tension in the string will be T2. So now we are supposed to find, now what will be the value of T1 by T2, or what will be the ratio of the tension, now T1 divided by T2. Now fairly simple here. Now listen carefully. Now how to obtain now T1 by T2. So now if you look at the first case, now by looking at the first case, now can you tell me now what are the forces that will be acting? Now what are the forces that will be acting on the pendulum box? So you already know now one force will be mg, that will always be acting vertically downward, and the other force will be the electrostatic force that will be acting in the vertically upward direction. So you already know a positive charge will be experiencing the electrostatic force now along the direction of the electric field. So that is the reason why now one more force that will be acting on the pendulum box will be the electrostatic force QE, that will be acting in the upward direction. And already given that tension will be T1. So remember, now that tension force will always be acting not towards the point of suspension, or that tension force will always be acting not towards the point of suspension. So now it is very clear. So what are the forces that will be acting on the pendulum box? Now weight mg will be acting vertically downward. The tension T1 will be acting vertically upward, and the electrostatic force QE will also be acting now vertically upward. So now from the diagram, or from the free body diagram, now you already know, now since the bob will be under equilibrium position, or since the pendulum bob will be remaining under equilibrium position, that is the reason why the sum of the upward forces should be equal to the downward force. So remember, now since the pendulum bob will be remaining under equilibrium, that is the reason why the sum of the upward forces should be equal to the downward force. So that is the reason why, by looking at the diagram, now what I can write? So I can write now tension force T1. So I can write now T1 plus QE will be numerically equal to mg. So I can write now T1 plus QE will be numerically equal to mg. That's the reason why. So T1 will be numerically equal to now mg minus QE. Now let us call it now equation 1. So already I got the value of T1. So T1 will be numerically equal to now mg minus qe. Now similarly, now when you come to the second case, now what will happen in the second case? Now can anybody now tell me now what are the external forces that will be acting on the pendulum box, or what are the external forces that will be acting on the pendulum box in case 2? So you already know in case 2, now what will happen? The electric field will be acting in the vertically downward direction. That's the reason why. Now what are the forces? Now what are the forces that will be acting in the downward direction? Now one will be the weight of the ball that will be acting in the vertically downward direction, and other will be the electrostatic force QE that will be acting in the downward direction. So remember, if you look at the diagram, so what are the external forces that will be acting on the pendulum box? So weight will always be acting now vertically downward. Now the electrostatic force, now QE, will also be acting in the vertically downward direction, but the tension will always be acting vertically upward, or the tension T2 will be acting in the upward direction. So that is the reason why, if you look at the diagram, now once again, now the pendulum box will be remaining under equilibrium, or the pendulum box will be remaining under equilibrium. That's the reason why now the upward force should be numerically equal to the sum of the downward forces, or the upward force will be numerically equal to the sum of the downward forces. So therefore, from the free body diagram, so what I can write, so T2 will be numerically equal to now mg plus qe. Now that will be now equation number 2, or we get now T2 will be numerically equal to now mg plus qe. Now what we want to find? Now we want to find the value of T1 by T2. Now let us see now how to find the value of T1 by T2. So therefore, now what I can do? So by looking at the equation, so therefore now I can write now T1 divided by T2 will be numerically equal to now mg minus qe, now whole divided by, now we got now mg plus qe. So very simple, now T1 we already got, T2 we already got, so T1 by T2 will be numerically equal to now mg minus qe, now divided by now mg plus qe. Now further, I will take now mg common in the numerator and mg common in the denominator. So what I am doing, now I am taking mg common in the numerator. So if I take mg common in the numerator, so what I am going to get? Now 1 minus qe now divided by mg, now whole divided by, now even in the denominator, now take mg as a common, so mg will be taken common, now what we get, now 1 plus qv, now divided by mg. So what will happen? Now mg and mg will be getting cancelled. Now finally we are getting the value of t1 by t2. So therefore now I can write, so t1 divided by t2 will be numerically equal to, now what I am getting, so finally now t1 by t2 will be numerically equal to, now 1 minus qe by mg whole divided by, now 1 plus qe by mg. So remember, now this will be the ratio of the tensions, or this will be the ratio of the tensions in the two cases, now T1 by, now T1 divided by T2 will be numerically equal to, now 1 minus QE divided by MG whole divided by, now 1 plus QE now divided by MG. So remember, now that will be the first application we got for the ratio of the tensions. So now let us see, now what will be the second application. Now based on the electric field, now what will be the second application we got? So one more very good application you got. So remember, now what will be the next application we got? So now the second important application, now listen, now very carefully, now again based on the simple pendulum, or again the application will be pertaining to the simple pendulum. Now listen, now very carefully. So again this will be the case 1. So what the case 1 will be saying, now let us say, now we got a pendulum bob. Now let us say we got a pendulum bob that will be exhibiting simple harmonic motion, or let us say we got a simple pendulum bob that will be exhibiting simple harmonic motion, and let us say the time period of the pendulum bob will be T1. So once again, now remember, now what the case will be saying, or what the application, so what the application will be saying, now let us say, so now let us say, now we got a pendulum bob, and let us say, now the simple pendulum will be exhibiting the simple harmonic motion, now about the equilibrium position, and let us say the time period of the simple pendulum will be T1. So that will be now case 1. Now similarly, now let us see, now what will be the case 2. So now in the case 2, now what I am doing, now the same pendulum bob, now the same pendulum bob will be given a positive charge Q, and now the pendulum box is made to oscillate in a vertical electric field, or the same pendulum box is made to oscillate in the vertical electric field. So now in this case, now let us see the time period of the single pendulum will be T2. So listen now very carefully. Now what the second case will be same. So now let us see. Now we got now the second case. Now remember, now the same pendulum bomb is made to execute the simple harmonic motion in a vertical electric field. And let us see, now in this case, that time period. So let us say, now in this case, the time period of the simple pendulum. So now let us see. Now once again, now let me repeat the concept here. Now let us again now see the second application. Now let us see. Now we got a simple pendulum that will be exhibiting the simple harmonic motion in the absence of the electric field, or consider a pendulum ball that will be exhibiting simple harmonic motion in the absence of the electric field. And let us say the time period of the pendulum ball will be T1. So now what we are doing, so now the same pendulum ball will be given a charge Q, and now we are applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. Now the same pendulum ball will be given a charge Q, and we are applying an electric field in the vertical upward direction. So now let us see, now in this case, the time period of the simple pendulum. Now let us see, now in this case, the time period of the simple pendulum will be T2. So now we are supposed to find, now what will be the ratio of the two time periods. Now again we need to find, now what will be the ratio of the two time periods. So once again, now listen the concept very carefully, or once again. So now once again, now listen the concept now very carefully. So now remember, now what I am trying to say, now consider a pendulum ball, or consider a pendulum ball that will be exhibiting simple harmonic motion in the absence of the electric field, or consider a simple pendulum that will be exhibiting the simple harmonic motion. And let us say the time period of the simple pendulum will be T1. So now what I am doing, so now I am giving a positive charge Q, you to the Bob or now I'm giving a charge you to the Bob and I'm applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E and now the pendulum is made to exhibit the simple harmonic motion now inside the electric field. So remember now what I am doing. So I am giving a positive charge Q to the pendulum bob and at the same time I am applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E and now the pendulum bob is made to execute the simple harmonic motion now inside the electric field. So now let us say now in this case the time period of the simple pendulum will be T2 or let us say now in this case the time period of the pendulum bob that will be exhibiting SHM will be T2. So now we need to find now what will be the value or what will be the ratio of T1 by T2 or we need to find now what will be the ratio of the time period in the first case to the time period in the second case. Now very simple. Now let us see now how to obtain the ratio of the two time periods. So now if you come to the first case, now you already know. So in the first case, the time period of the simple pendulum will be given by the formula now 2π into under root of L/G. So let us call now equation number 1. So you already know in the first case where the electric field will be absent or in the first case the electric field will be absent. That's the reason why the time period of the pendulum bob can be written by the formula now 2π into under root of L/G. Now similarly, now what will be the time period in the second case or what will be the time period of the pendulum bob in the second case? Now remember, in the second case, the time period will be written by now T2 will be numerically equal to 2π into under root of L divided by net acceleration. So remember the important concept, in the second case the time period of the simple pendulum will be written by the expression. So T2 will be numerically equal to 2π into under root of L divided by the net acceleration. So now our job will be to find the net acceleration of the bob. Or now I need to find now what will be the net acceleration of the bob now inside the electric field. So how to obtain the net acceleration of the bob or how to get the effective acceleration of the bob now inside the electric field? Now very simple. Now what do you do? Now if you take the pendulum bob, so if you take the pendulum bob Can anybody now tell me now what are the external forces that will be acting on the pendulum bob, or what are the external forces that will be acting on the pendulum bob? So one you are already familiar. Now one will be the weight of the bob will be acting vertically downward. So mg will be acting vertically downward. And what is the other force? The electric field will be acting upward. Now remember, now the electric field will be applied in the upward direction. That's the reason why the bob will be experiencing an electrostatic force QED in the upward direction. So if you look at the diagram, so it is very clear from the free body diagram. Now what are the forces that will be acting on the pendulum bob? Now mg will be acting vertically downward, and QE will be acting now vertically upward. So now can anybody now tell me now what will be the net force that will be acting on the pendulum bob, or what will be the net force that will be acting on the pendulum bob? So if I draw the free body diagram, now this will be our pendulum bob. Now mg will be acting vertically downward, and the electrostatic force QE will be acting vertically upward. Now that is the reason why now what will be the net force that will be acting on the pendulum bob. So remember, the net force that will be acting on the pendulum bob will be numerically equal to now mg minus QE. So always now remember, now weight will be dominating when compared to the electrostatic force, or the weight of the pendulum bob will be dominating when compared to the electrostatic force. That is the reason why the net downward force that will be acting on the pendulum bob will be given by, so F net will be numerically equal to, so mg minus QE. So remember, now since the weight of the pendulum bob, or since the weight of the pendulum bob will be greater than the electrostatic force, that is the reason why the net downward force that will be acting on the bob will be given by, now F net will be numerically equal to now mg minus QE. Now you already know from the Newton's second law, now F net can be written, now mass into net acceleration will be numerically equal to now mg minus QE. So apply the Newton's second law. So according to that, the net force that will be acting on the pendulum bob will be numerically equal to now mass into net acceleration will be numerically equal to now mg minus QE. So therefore, now what will be the value of net acceleration? So net acceleration will become, now bring m to the denominator, so we get now mg minus QE now divided by M, or if I split the denominator, so I can write the net acceleration will be numerically equal to now G minus QE now divided by M. So remember, now this will be the net acceleration of the pendulum ball that will be exhibiting SHM in the vertical electric field, or this will be the net acceleration of the pendulum ball that will be exhibiting SHM in the vertical electric field that will be given by, so A net will be numerically equal to now G minus QE divided by M. So now what you do, now substitute the value of the net acceleration in this formula. So wherever we got A net, so A net can be replaced by now G minus QE divided by M. Now let's see now what we are going to get. So if I remove this diagram, now what I will do, so wherever we got the net acceleration, or wherever we got A net, that can be replaced by G minus QE by M. So therefore, now I can write, now T2 will be numerically equal to 2 pi into under root of now L are divided by G minus QE divided by M. So now let us call, so if I remove this whole thing, so now not required, so if I remove the whole thing, so now you call now this one as equation number 2. So now I can easily find now what will be the ratio of T1 by T2, or now I can find out now what will be the ratio of the time period now T1 divided by T2. So therefore now I can write now T1 divided by T2 will be numerically equal to now T1 we already got now 2 pi into under root of L by G, so whole are divided by 2 pi into under root of L now divided by G minus, so L are divided by G minus now QE divided by M. So what I can do, now 2 pi get cancelled. Now what I will do, I will put in one bracket, so therefore the time period T1 divided by the time period T2 will be numerically equal to, now what I get, 1, 2, 3, 4, so the fourth term will be coming to the numerator, so I get now L by G now multiplied by now G minus QE divided by M now whole divided by L. So if I simplify, now what I am getting, so under root of L by G now multiplied by now G minus QE divided by M now divided by L. So therefore now what will happen, now L and L will be getting cancelled. Now finally we can find out now what will be, now finally we can find out now what will be the ratio of T1 by T2. So therefore, now I can write, now T1 divided by T2 or the numerical equal to, now what I am getting, now G minus QD divided by M, now whole divided by G. Now further, now what I will do, now T1 divided by T2 will be numerical equal to, now what I will do, from the numerator I will take G common, or from the numerator I will be taking G common. So if I take G common, so what I get, now 1 minus QE, now divided by MG, now whole are divided by G. So very simple, now what I am doing, from the numerator, now G can be taken common. So what I am getting, now 1 minus QE, now divided by MG, now whole divided by G. So G and G are the getting cancelled. So G and G are the getting cancelled. So therefore, now what we are getting, now T1 divided by T2 will be numerical equal to, now under root of 1 minus QE, now divided by MG. So remember, now that will be the ratio of the time period. So T1 divided by T2 will be numerical equal to, now under root of, now 1 minus QE, now divided by MG. So that will be, now one more application we got, or that will be, now one more application we got, now based on the simple pendulum, or one more very good application we got, now based on the simple pendulum. So till here I think everybody may have understood. So now I will tell you quickly, now one more very good application. So now listen carefully, now one more important application. So one more important application, third one. Now here, now remember what I am doing, now listen very carefully. Now let us say, now we got a pendulum box that has been given a positive charge Q, and the pendulum box will be exhibiting simple harmonic motion. The simple pendulum will be exhibiting simple harmonic motion. Now let us say, in the vertical electric field. So let us say, I am applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. So now this will be, once again, now case 1, now this will be, so now listen, what I am doing. So now, let me complete the diagram, then I will come to you. Now what is the meaning we got? So let me complete the diagram, then I will come back. So what is the application we got? Right, so now let us say, in this case, the time period of the simple pendulum will be T1, and let us say the time period of the simple pendulum in this case will be T2. So now if you look at the diagram, now one more important application we got. Now remember, now the case 1, so what I got? I got a pendulum bob of mass m that has been given a positive charge q, and remember the pendulum bob is made to oscillate, or the pendulum bob is made to exhibit simple harmonic motion in the vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. So now remember, now case 1, now we got a pendulum bob of mass m that has been given a positive charge q, and now we are applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E, and the bob will be exhibiting the simple harmonic motion. And let us say the time period of the simple pendulum will be T1, or let us say the time period of the pendulum bob will be T1. So once again, now remember case 1, so what we got? So we got a pendulum bob of mass m that has been given a positive charge q, and now it is made to exhibit simple harmonic motion in the vertical electric field. So let us say that time period of the pendulum will be T1. So now what I am doing, now without disturbing the bob, or without disturbing the pendulum bob, now what I am doing, I am reversing the direction of the electric field, or now I am reversing the direction of the electric field. So now let us say the time period of the simple pendulum will be T2. So very very simple. So in the previous case, now the electric field will be applied in the vertically upward direction, and the time period of the simple pendulum will be T1. And in the second case, now what we are doing, we are reversing the direction of the electric field, and let us say the time period of the pendulum bob will be T2. So now once again, we are supposed to find, we need to find, now what will be the ratio of the two time periods, or what will be the ratio of the time periods of the pendulum bob in case 1 and in case 2. So very simple. So how to write in the first case? So in the first case, the time period will be given by, now T1 will be numerically equal to 2 pi into under root of L divided by, so we got net acceleration. So now first, now what you do, now find the net acceleration of the bob inside the electric field, or find the net acceleration of the bob now inside the electric field and substitute there. So if you look at the diagram, now what are the forces that will be acting on the ball? So it is very clear. Now weight mg will be acting vertically downward, and the electrostatic force QE will be acting upward. So it is very clear. Now mg will be acting in the downward direction, and the electrostatic force QE will be acting in the upward direction. So therefore, now what will be the net downward force that will be acting on the pendulum ball, or what will be the net downward force that will be acting on the pendulum ball? So by looking at the free body diagram, you can clearly see, so net force will be numerically equal to now mg minus QE, but we already know from the Newton's second law, now F net will be numerically equal to M into A net will be numerically equal to mg minus QE. So therefore, the net acceleration will be numerically equal to now mg minus QE now divided by M. Now what you do? Now split the denominator. So if you are splitting the denominator, so what we get? So A net will be numerically equal to, now what I get? Now G minus QE divided by M. Now G minus QE divided by M. Now that you substitute in this equation. So wherever we got net acceleration, that can be replaced by now G minus QE divided by M. So therefore, now T1 will be numerically equal to 2 pi into under root of L divided by G minus now QE divided by M. So we are getting now T1. Will be numerically equal to 2 pi now under root of L now divided by now G minus QE divided by M. So that will be the time period of the pendulum in the first case, or that will be the time period of the simple pendulum when the electric field will be acting in the upper direction. So now let us find out now what will be the time period of the pendulum, or what will be the time period of the pendulum when it will be oscillating in the downward electric field, or what will be the time period of the pendulum ball in the downward electric field. So now, if we take this diagram, so case 1 I can remove because you already got the value of P1. So now let us see now what will happen in the second case. So now in the second case, now can you tell me now what are the external forces that will be acting on the pendulum ball? Now remember, now the electric field has been reversed, or the electric field will be acting in the downward direction. So what are the external forces that that will be acting on the pendulum box. So it is very clear. Now one force will be mg that will be acting vertically downward. So the weight of the pendulum bomb will be acting downward. And you also know the electrostatic force QE. Now the electrostatic force QE will also be acting in the downward direction. So not only the weight will be acting in the downward direction, nor even the electrostatic force will also be acting in the downward direction. So now can you tell me now what will be the net downward force, or what will be the net downward force that will be acting on the pendulum box? So by looking at the diagram, now one can clearly see now what will be the net downward force that will be acting on the pendulum box. So look at the free body diagram. So I can write the net force that will be acting on the pendulum box will be numerically equal to not mg plus qe. But you already know from the Newton's second law, now net force will be numerically equal to m net, m into a net will be numerically equal to not mg plus qe. So therefore, the net acceleration will be numerically equal to, now you get now mg plus qe, now whole divided by small m, now split the denominator. So a net will be numerically equal to, now what we get, now g plus qe, now divided by m. So splitting the denominator, so what I am going to get? So we get now g plus qe now divided by m. So now let us find out now what will be the time period in the second case, or what will be the time period of the pendulum bob in the second case. So how to write the formula for time period? So now I can say in the second case, now T2 will be numerically equal to 2 pi into under root of L divided by net acceleration. So therefore, now T2 will be numerically equal to 2 pi into under root of L divided by, now net acceleration we already got, now g plus qe now divided by m. So we already got the net acceleration, so L are divided by now g plus qe divided by m. So we got the time period of the oscillating pendulum, or we got the time period of the oscillating pendulum in the second case, that will be given by T2 will be numerically equal to 2 pi under root of L divided by g plus qe divided by m. So now if you take in this one, so now what is our intention? If you remember, now what we need to find? So now we are supposed to find now what will be the ratio of T1 divided by T2, or we are asked to find now what will be the ratio of the time period in the first case to the second case. So therefore, now T1 divided by T2. So T1 you already got. If I substitute, so 2 pi into under root of, so 2 pi, if I remove this one, so T1 we already got 2 pi under root of L, now divided by, now G minus QE, now divided by M, now all divided by, now T2, we also got, so T2 will be 2 pi, now under root of L divided by, so if I remove T1, so if I substitute, so I remove the whole thing, so that I can simplify the given expression. So T2 we got 2 pi under root of L, now divided by, now G plus QE, now divided by M. So therefore, now what will happen? Now 2 pi and 2 pi will be getting cancelled. So therefore, now further, now what I can do? Now this can be further written. Now T1 divided by T2 will be numerically equal to now whole root of, so we get now L divided by G minus QE divided by M, now multiplied by now G plus QE divided by M, now whole divided by L. As the reason why now L and L will be getting cancelled. So what we are getting, so that is the reason why now T1 divided by T2 will be numerically equal to now under root of, now what we get, now G plus QE divided by M over divided by G minus QE divided by M. Now this can be further simplified, or I can write now T1 divided by T2 will be numerically equal to, now what I can do, I can take G common, or I will take now gravity common in the numerator. So if I take G common, so what I get, now 1 plus QE now divided by MG, now whole divided by now E1 in the denominator, now take G common, so what I get, now 1 minus QE now divided by MG. So gravity and gravity will be getting cancelled. So finally, now what will be left over? Now T1 divided by T2 will be numerically equal to now under root of 1 plus QE divided by MG, now whole divided by now 1 minus QE now divided by MG. So remember, now that will be the ratio of the time period, or that will be the ratio of the time period of the simple pendulum in the two different cases. In case 1, we are applying the uniform electric field in the vertically upward direction, and in the second case, the electric field will be applied in the vertically downward direction. So, so we can find out now what will be the ratio of the time period. So T1 divided by T2 will be numerically equal to now 1 plus QE divided by mg whole divided by now 1 minus QE divided by mg. So hope students you have understood whatever concepts I told today. Excellent concepts we got for the application of electric field. So go through all whatever being taught today, go through all of them and give your precious comments. Always we keep on saying that for all the lecturers who are coming on the dais and putting their 100%, 200%, give them their, your precious comments. So it's a kind of motivation for all of us. It's a kind of inspiration for all of us. So do put your comments in the comment box so that every time we come on the stage and we can blast the stage with lot of good concepts. So hoping everybody would have understood. So today that's all girls. So I'll be stopping here. So thank you for your cooperation. Thank you. Thanks a lot.